Welcome to the BEC podcast. My name is Rasmus Bæk, and today I'm very happy to welcome one of the young players we have seen a lot to in the last couple of years, and I'm sure we will see a lot more. Delphine Delruy from France, welcome. Delphine, every time I see you and Tom walk on court, I'm not sure where it's going to end, because you guys seem to actually surprise a lot of people every time you walk on court. Are you sometimes surprised how well it goes for you and Tom?
Yes, sometimes. I think we always want to do our best on court when we enter the court, but this last month we play really good. We beat a lot of really good pairs, and I think we show that we can be a really good pair in the world. So yes, I think it was fast for us because we are only 22, so we reach top 10 now, and really fast. So we are happy and a bit surprised that it goes that well so quickly.
Yeah, reaching top 10 in the world, Delphine. How was that? Seeing that on the ranking for the very first time, how was that?
It was amazing for us. It was one of our goals, and to achieve that, we are really proud of that. And for France also, because top 10 in the world in France in badminton is not every day, so we are proud and really happy.
I remember a few years ago, now 2 years ago, we were in Belarus, in Minsk, where you and Tom won a medal. I remember what you said to me afterwards. I'm so proud, and I'm so happy. Are you still proud knowing that now everybody's looking at you now? You are the ones to beat?
Yes, of course we are proud to win this medal, but now we know that the rest of the players knows that we can beat them, and we can be a favorite to the tournament now at the European Championship. So yes, we are proud, and this time we want to win the gold medal for sure.
How is it to know that all the players want to beat you now? Now you're not the underdog anymore.
Yeah, it's maybe more stressful for us, because now the players know us, and it's a bit more difficult to surprise them and to win also. So of course more stress, but I think we handle this quite too good. So we are happy to have this kind of situation when we enter court.
Delphine, of course you have a medal from the European Games, and nobody can take that away from you. It's an impressive achievement. You have won tournaments as well. You have beaten a lot of good pairs, but what do you and Tom need to do to make that big breakthrough where, okay, now we are like a top player? You know what I mean? Yeah.
I think it's mostly about some details on the game. We work a lot on the physical part last year because of the lockdown. We had time to work on that, and I think we still have a lot of work to do in that part, and it will make us even better. And I think the tactical part is also a part where we have to improve to be the best.
We have seen Tom play with Ronan. We have seen you also play in the women's doubles. We don't see that much anymore. It's all about mixed doubles.
Yes, we stop women's double and men's double for the Olympic qualification, because in mixed it work really good, and we have good chance to qualify. And in women's double it was more difficult. We were a bit low on the ranking, so we decided in January 2020 to stop until the Olympic Games, and then we'll see if I can play again women's double or not after.
Would you like to?
Yes, sometimes I miss play women's double, but I don't know if I can be top 5 in the two categories in the future, so I will have to think about it, but for sure I miss women's double.
What can be the pros and cons for and against playing two categories?
I think women's double is really difficult physically, and to play both 2 years ago was really tough for me on the physical part, but also mentally, because it's not the same game at all, so it was difficult to do both, but I think now I'm better on the physical part, and I really enjoy to play women's double, so I don't know, I really have to speak with the coaches also.
We spoke to Ronan earlier in one of our podcasts, and Ronan and Audrey, they won a medal at the European Championships. And it's also quite clear to me that you and Tom is aiming for some of those things. You already have a European Games medal. But what makes you believe that you can go even further and not only winning a medal, but maybe winning a gold medal or Olympic medal or World Championship medal? What makes you believe that you can do that?
I think with Tom, since the beginning, we always believe that we can be the best. And we won a lot in the junior, and now we beat almost everybody in Europe. So we have a lot of confidence, and we know that we can win this championship. And for the Olympics or World Championship, I think we beat some really good pairs from Indonesia, Malaysia. Not the Chinese yet, but I think we have the game to beat that kind of pair.
Where do you guys need to improve? You said that you're working on the physical part, also on the mental part of the game. But what do you need to do to beat the best Chinese? Because that's basically what you're missing out as for now.
I think we have to be better in defense. They're really because they attack really good, and if we can be relaxed and control the game in defense, we can be better, I think. Because when we have the attack, I think we are really good, and we are really aggressive. It's on court, but when we have to play defense, it's not.
That's where you lag a bit. Yeah. Delphine, you are in the early 20s. So is Tom. So is a lot of the players actually in the French team. How would you describe the French team right now?
Yes, the French team is really young. I think we have a lot of really good players. Antoine is only 25. She has already two medals at the European Championship. And we have a lot of young, like my brother, William Villegier, Tom, Eloi. We have really good players. And we have a good spirit in the team. So at the training, it's really nice. We see that we improve a lot together. And that's why I think it works.
Yeah, now you're mentioning your brother. A lot of every time you know that brothers and sisters are playing badminton, you will ask, "Are you going to play together one day?" So now I'm asking you, are you and your brother going to play together one day?
I don't know if he is the best. I will play with him.
But if he's not the best, you stick with another one.
Yes, I think.
But how is it, I think, to know that your brother's also here at the European Championships? Because you're used to travel now with Tom, and your brother might not be here, but then sometimes he is. How is it actually to have that experience together?
I'm really happy to be with him here, and I'm a bit more stressed because when he plays, I want him to win, so a bit more stressed. But I'm really happy, and it's more fun to travel with more players because. Like you said, with Tom, we travel mostly two of us. So now we have a bigger team, so it's nice.
Delphine, in February 2020 in Lyon, the French team won a very crucial medal, very important medal. It was the first one ever. Right now, the guys seeing this interview, you can actually see some of the celebration pictures. And you are celebrating because you were actually on court when you and Anne actually won that match, which secured the medal. How was that to win that medal on home soil as the very first one?
Yeah, it was crazy. There are a lot of crowd in the hall, and we really wanted to win this medal because it was the first one, and we had a really good team, and we knew that it was our chance to win. And in France, it was amazing. All the crowd was behind us, and we had a lot of support, and yeah, we are really proud of that medal.
And 1 month later, everything locks down. An anticlimax, you can say, because you were on the top, everything was great, all England, and then everything was turning black. How was that?
It was a weird situation. We lost at the England, and then we were in lockdown at home. We can't play badminton, just 2 months at home with just physical training, and it was weird, but I think I needed time with my family also, so I handled this quite good. And then the summer training was really nice with all the team. We can practice at the National Center, but then we miss to play tournaments and to travel for sure.
National Training Center is in Paris, a beautiful city, a very big city. How was it to be in the middle of your country, in the capital, and everything was actually closed? Nobody was allowed to go anywhere. How was that?
It was weird to see Paris without people on the street, and everything was closed, like you said. So it was really weird. We were the only one allowed to train and to move in the country. So yeah, it was a bit weird, but we were lucky to have access to the National Center.
And now, a year later, and a little more than 1 year later, the world is turning into a more normal thing, but it's not normal yet. Are you nervous when you travel, do you think?
No, not really nervous. I know that when we leave for a tournament, everyone has a COVID test negative, and we take precaution to avoid to be sick. So I'm not nervous, but we don't know before tournaments if we can leave or not. We have to wait for the test and everything. So a bit more stress before tournaments, but when we are in the tournaments, it's fine.
Devin, hopefully you and I will be talking together for the next 8-10 years. If we go forward in time 10 years from now, where are you? Are you still playing badminton on elite level, or where do you see yourself?
I don't know. I think I will still play badminton. I will be 32, so it's not that old for badminton. So yeah, I think I want to play as long as possible at the highest level. So I hope I will still be in the badminton world.
Did you take part in the 2024 Olympic Games in Paris then?
Yeah.
Do you think you will be there?
Sorry?
At the Paris Olympics in 2024, will you be part?
Yes, I hope so. I want to. That's the goal, to win the best medal at Paris. It would be amazing.
Devin, I wish you all the best of luck, and thanks for coming. And remember to follow Delphine Delruy on social media. And also thank you for watching the podcast.